Do you think that you are completely alone in your quiet room while listening to this video? Maybe you are wrong, because jinns, one of the seven types of beings created by God in the universe, can see you, but you cannot see them. But is it possible to communicate with them? Are they superior to humans? What do they look like? Do they haunt people? Can they do harm? How many years do they live? What do they eat and drink? In this video, we answer all these questions and more. Are you ready? Because the truth may surprise you. Djinn, also known as jinn or as genies, are a type of spiritual unseen creature found in many modern and ancient religions and beliefs, including Abrahamic religions. These invisible beings, which can take various forms according to some interpretations, have the ability to have sexual intercourse with humans, and have the ability to control and influence them. Man, who was sent as a caliph over the jinns and all the creatures, is superior to the jinns in terms of intelligence, reason, memory, judgment, and worship, as well as his creation feature. However, some jinns do not recognize the superiority of human beings, but leave them in a difficult situation and do their best to make them dependent on them. Those who do not know the nature of jinns seek help from them. For this purpose, some people organize jinn summoning sessions and communicate with them. Christianity generally regards demons and devils as the same entity. They are forces of evil, rebelling against the divine. In Christianity, a jinn, or even many jinns, can possess a person. These demons can be exorcised from the person they have possessed. The phenomenon of exorcism exists in Christianity. The activities of demons can be summarized in three main groups: their sexual approach to humans, sex, their support of false worship, religious, and their torment of humans, sadism, violence. The sacred text warns people against engaging in jinn-related activities such as fortune-telling, witchcraft, necromancy, sorcery, and approaching the dead for help. Jinn are believed to have superior abilities and the power to influence people's minds. It is believed that jinn can use dreams to give their own messages. Can the jinn be controlled by man and serve him? Yes, jinns can be controlled by humans, and the greatest proof of this is that the Prophet Solomon ruled over the jinns. Although there are a number of ways and procedures, liaising with the jinn requires a guide and a competent person. If there is no method, principle, and guide, there is a possibility of making mistakes and being harmed by the jinn. If those who are engaged in such things are not knowledgeable in this matter, then they will be attacked by evil spirits. They will be dominated by them and become their playthings. As a result, jinn sometimes encourage such people to pride and arrogance, caress and spoil them, and when the time comes, they take them under their influence by frightening and threatening them, and make them speak and do things on their own account. As a matter of fact, in India in the 20th century, Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani became the victim of such evil spirits. He wanted to fight against Indian yogism on the path of Fakirism in the name of Islam, but was attacked by evil spirits and became their puppet. The evil spirits first made him accept that he was a mujahideen, then they made him believe that he was the Mahdi, and then they made him believe that he was Jesus' Messiah. Finally, he went as far as to say, "God has appeared to me and appeared in me." Evil spirits quickly establish contact with the evil ones and can lead them to insanity. Can jinn and devils harm people? Jinns can haunt people in some cases and seduce them in different ways and at different levels. Every sin committed is a door and a window to the devil and evil jinns. Particularly sensitive people, those with corrupted souls, Those who live an idle life away from prayers and the atmosphere of prayers quickly fall under the influence of jinns. Sorcery is the forcing of a person to do something he, she does not want to do against his, her consciousness and will. According to Islamic belief, sorcery is one of the biggest sins and is forbidden. A person who has been bewitched is haunted by a jinn. Various physical ailments such as headaches, nausea, dizziness, sleep disturbances, aches and pains in the body can be symptoms of demonic possession. Psychological symptoms such as depression, anxiety, constant restlessness, fear, or panic attacks can be caused by the effects of demonic possession. Jinn possession can cause significant changes in an individual's behavior. Behavioral changes such as aggression, outbursts of anger, irritability, social withdrawal, or excessive inattention can be examples of these symptoms. People who are haunted can sometimes have strange psychological experiences. Experiences such as hearing voices, seeing shadow figures, having strange dreams or nightmares can be signs of demonic possession. Jinn possession can cause the affected person to become mentally and emotionally weakened. Symptoms such as decreased cognitive functions, lack of concentration, memory problems, or hopelessness may be observed. These symptoms alone do not prove that a person is possessed, as there may be other medical or psychological problems with similar symptoms. However, these symptoms should not be ignored, and an appropriate specialist should be consulted if a jinn haunting is suspected. Jinns can haunt people not only through magic but also in other ways. Some places are believed to be haunted. Being in places such as abandoned buildings, cemeteries, or areas of historical importance can increase the risk of demon possession. If a person is exposed to negative energies or thoughts, it can prepare the ground for the possession. Negative emotions such as anger, jealousy, or hatred can create an opening to attract jinn. Some people claim to have contact with jinns during necromancy or spiritual experiences. Such experiences can increase the likelihood of being haunted by jinns. Sometimes, in houses, jinns torment the inhabitants of that house by sight or sound. Sometimes a meal for 5 people is cooked in the house, and it is finished immediately as if 10 people had eaten. Even though 2 or 3 people live in the house, it sounds as if 10 people live there. The houses in which the jinns dwell are usually the houses of people who do not live the belief in God, and the jinns and devils benefit from the food, property, wives and children of those houses and become partners. Jinn eat, drink, and marry just like humans. They can also have sexual intercourse just like humans. Their diet is odor. They do not eat like us because they are energy beings. They love the smell of cooked rice. Also, the smell of meat with bone residue is their favorite smell. They love cigarette smoke. The unbelievers love the smell of blood, pus, animal droppings. They love very dirty people. They especially love the smells of dirty people. They are mostly found in bathrooms and toilets in houses. Nusaybin jinns are very famous. Unbelieving jinns possess the human body. When they take possession of a human body, they rejoice as if they had settled in a mansion on the Bosphorus. They are very comfortable there. They use the mouth, eyes, brain, and heart of that person. When they have to get out, they scream, as if they are being torn from their mother's lap. Their lifespan is very long. They can live 1,000–1,500 years. They have no commercial concerns. Since they feed on human waste, they don't have to work. Azrael takes their life too. They will enter heaven or hell together with us. In this video about jinns, we have examined in detail these beings that affect people's lives and create a mysterious atmosphere. We have shared a lot of information about how they look, how they live, and how they affect people. Although there are many beliefs and stories about the existence of jinns, the purpose of this video is not only to arouse curiosity, but also to encourage further research on this subject. Remember that when talking about supernatural beings, we should always be respectful and respect various beliefs and cultures.